In this chapter, we'll look at repository provider. Do you remember we talked about the typical structure of an app earlier? Let's make the picture a little more detailed and look at the architecture we'll usually use when using the block library. This architecture can also be applied when using a state management library other than the block library. In the apps we made until now, all data-related parts were done locally. However, most modern apps have a data layer like this picture because they interact with a database or a remote API server. The one marked as data provider here communicates directly with the API server and performs CRUD operation, that is, create, read, update, and delete operation. On the other hand, the repository hides the implementation details of the data provider from the developer. For example, when you need to communicate with a remote API multiple times to get the desired result, it makes it appear as one communication to the developer so that the developer does not need to know the complexity. As you can see in the picture, a repository created by many apps, and a function in the repository may be needed in multiple qubits or blocks. However, due to the nature of this repository, only access to the widget tree is required, and there is no need to listen for changes. Flutter block provides a separate repository provider that makes it easy to access this repository. Since this repository provider is used as a dependent injection widget, it can be used to simply share data on the widget tree. Access to the repository provider can be done using the context.read extension method or using the repository providers of static method. If you need multiple repository providers, you can use multi-repository provider for convenience. It is quite similar to multi-block provider. Among the widgets provided by Flutter block up to this point, we have covered block provider, multi-block provider, block builder, block listener, and block consumer in the examples. The widgets we haven't covered yet include multi-block listener, repository provider, and multi-repository provider. Multi-block listener, repository provider, and multi-repository provider will be covered in later apps. Personally, I didn't feel the need to use block selector because it doesn't seem to have much benefit compared to using the context select extension method.